Hi guys, I'm Lily and thanks for watching us. If you don't know, back in 1996, the first robot vacuum cleaner came out and it was officially mass-produced to the market in 2001. Now it's 2022, right? And after 20 years, we know that the smart home appliance producers try their best to keep up with their customers' needs. Today, we will show you the new Redkey R2 model that deserves your attention. So let's see what's in the box. Okay. So as we can see, there is a robot itself and the charging dock, the power adapter, two side brushes, and the dust bracket with a duster. This is a dust brush, remote control, quick quiet, and the manual. Yeah, that's all. You can find two buttons on the surface. They are recharge and power buttons. By short pressing the recharge button, you will let the robot to go to recharge itself or pause. And if you press it longer, then it will turn it on into the fixed point cleaning. Okay, let me tell you once again, okay? Recharge button, short press, recharging or pause. Long pressing, fixed point cleaning. So what about the power button itself? So is there any kind of a tricky thing with that? I'm telling you, there is actually, yes, there is. So by short pressing the power button, it will pause or continue cleaning. By long pressing, you will turn it off or on. So let me tell you once again, power button, short press, cleaning or pause. Long press, power on and off. Oh yeah, there's one more thing. If you press two buttons simultaneously, you will get access to the network configuration. So basically, when you have any problems with your internet and to reconnect Redkey to your network, all you have to do is to press the recharge and power buttons at the same time. I think it's very convenient. So, by the way, this is another quick intro about the light state. Light state is a language that you can communicate with your Redkey. Now it's time to show you a quick Redkey R2 anatomy. Let's start from the side face. So there are one infrared receiving sensor and two collision sensors. And it's covered with a nice bumper that prevents any furniture damage. If you ask me what is infrared sensor and what is the collision sensor, so an infrared sensor is an electric instrument that is used to sense certain characteristics of its surroundings. And a collision sensor is a piece of electric safety equipment that detects an impact through the vibrations. And after opening, we can see that there is a removable 2-in-1 water tank. Like this one. So our 2-in-1 water tank dust box with a HEPA filter, which is great that it saves a lot of space. I think like in 2022, 2-in-1 water and dust tank, they're just getting viral. And what about on the bottom? There are lots of things that we can share. And universal wheel right here, two charging electrodes, and there's a battery, which is 2600 mAh, two side brushes, and four boundary-like sensors, and covered with a middle model, like right here, and the rolling brush, and two buffer driving wheels. Yeah, that's all. So now, let's take a look at the charging dock. What is that? Oh, it's right here. On the top, there is the charging indicator. The signal transmitter is located in the middle of the charging base. And the charging electrodes are right here to get connected to the charging electrodes, yeah, which is located over here. And the last cable charge is on the left and the right sides, yeah. We recommend to users charge their robot first. To do that, place the charging home base against the wall, plug in adapter, and the signal light on the charging home base will flash. Don't forget to remove all of the obstacles about 1 meter distance and two sides and 2 meters ahead. You can either place the robot to the charging dock manually or press the home button on the remote controller to direct the robot to charge the home base for charging. So while your robot is on the charge, how about we will show you an app connection tutorial? Yeah, like right now. To do that, like all you have to do is to find the Redkey in your smartphone application store, like App Store or Android Store. You can just scan the QR code as below and download the app, register and log in. And set up the network configuration by pressing the following two buttons below. Enter the Wi-Fi password and make sure that your Wi-Fi is 2.4 GHz. are, if you are an iOS user, then you should go to the settings, WLAN, choose the red key, network connection. When it's successfully connected, reopen the app. And for Android users, you just need to follow their application decades, select connect the network. The last but not least part of is to check up your application in network connection status or not, like, and wait to the network configuration to finish. So finally, you were successfully connected to the app. A robot control dashboard will appear when the connection is finished. Then you have to just enjoy the happiness and amazing part of your, you know, wet and dry vacuum cleaner. The first time the robot is operated, it will map and memorize the whole house by means of the ladder before the cleaning cycle. Redkey's new robot vacuum comes with three cleaning modes: Eco, Medium, and Turbo. Eco mode is the lowest settings and designed to clean with the lowest noise level. It's also the mode that helps conserve the battery. The Medium mode, it comes with increasing suction power to clean the dirt and debris on the floor. And the Turbo mode is the highest suction power and the settings you choose if you want to deeply clean dirt and debris you can see in your carpet. So to operate using the remote control, this one, point the remote control to the robot and select your desired commands down below. You can also select your commands through the robot and onboard control menu. And here, before using your remote control for the first time, install two AA batteries, which are included, and they also like following options. So there are schedule, three types power levels, and there is like back home, time, manual control, on and pause, age mode. So what? Let me tell you one by one. On and pause modes. To start cleaning, just press the power button on the remote control. The robot will plan the cleaning routine automatically. So three types power levels, press the power levels button, which looks like three strokes. It will allow you to select the desired power levels like Eco, Medium, and Turbo. The suction power is 2500 Pascal. So age mode, I like the age mode. As you can see, it's right here. And the age cleaning mode, the robot will do cleaning along with the corners, walls around the furniture, and edges with its side brushes. So what about back home? So press the home button, the robot will direct itself automatically to charging station. By the way, don't forget to remove the water tank before you're charging it, okay? So what about schedule? So the robot is provided with a schedule function in order to provide a maximum efficiency cleaning. You can schedule the robot cleaning time as you want. When a certain time is scheduled, the robot will leave the charging home base and start working at schedule time. Redkey provides 2-in-1 water and dustbin tank. The water tank part is 220 ml and dustbin size is 250. Open the robot and fill up with the water, install the 2-in-1 water tank to the robot. There should be a click sound. Attach the water closet and a duster bracket and install the duster bracket to the bottom on the robot. So as you can see, Redkey performs really well picking up all this debris on the floor and the carpet. While it was like making a map around the room, it cleaned all of this dirt under bed and table, and it was really fun to use it. And of course, like, we found that like when it comes to the carpet, it just automatically increased its power, and it turned on the medium and the turbo mode. It could pick up all of the hair and the debris under the high carpets. And you know, like, cleaning the hardback carpet, it's really hard even for handheld vacuum cleaners. We also turned on the age mode. According to the age mode, it cleaned all of the corners. It showed like super great results because it picked up all of this debris on the corner, and you know, it's really hard for this kind of vacuum cleaners, I mean robot vacuum cleaners. And we tried also the mopping system. The mopping system actually not bad, I mean it's good, but how to say, if you set really high requirements at cleaning like dark spots on their, I mean like on their and a pail or anything else, it will clean but not clean that much enough, so you have to use like manual to clean the spots. You would like to make this kind of wet cleaning once like in 2 or 3 days, it will be just perfect. That's my personal review about this Redkey R2. The price for this item is only 189.99 euro, and it's only 250 bucks. I believe that just for this price, the vacuum cleaner who has you know, application and remote controlling system, it has also 2-in-1 water and dust tank, and also the one charge lasts for almost like 2 hours performance. I think just it's perfect for those who would like to give it a try to buy the vacuum cleaner. So I believe that's all. So thank you guys for watching our video, and hope you guys enjoyed it. Like, if you have any kind of concerns, advices, please write in the comment section below, and also please don't forget to subscribe to the Muchen World. I will be really appreciated. Bye.